Welcome back, everybody. Mike Lyons here in the First Alert Weather Center. Thursday, more heat, more humidity, very un-November-like across the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. And that trend continues on Friday and Saturday. But by Sunday night, a cool front slides through. That will drop our temperatures a little bit toward the first part of next week. You can see just a few high clouds across the peninsula this afternoon. But up the road, got a pretty good cold front that is cutting its way through the midsection of the country. That will be here late Sunday night into Monday, increasing our rain chances toward the end of the weekend. As you can see, Sunday, especially Sunday night and into Monday morning, the best chances for rain. After that, drier. But until the front arrives, it's more of the same, meaning warm and humid, overnight lows way above average, and daytime highs on Friday in the mid-range of the 80s. The other factor, as that cool front gets closer, it increases the pressure gradient. So gusty winds starting Friday and continuing through the weekend. That means some rough boating conditions across South Florida. You can see the forecast highs still above average as we head through the next few days. In the tropics, some good news. What's left of Rena? No more. The storm is no longer officially a tropical cyclone, just a low pressure system, just due east, so to speak, of Newfoundland and the Canadian Maritimes. And again, no threat. Rest of the tropics, nice and quiet. Forecast for tonight, a few clouds, warm and humid, overnight low 72. Across South Florida tomorrow, a quick shower, breezy, high temperature of 84. And for boating, getting rough, seas up to 5 feet, inland waters pretty choppy. First Alert 7-day forecast, South Florida's most accurate. Again, the rain on Sunday night into Monday, and some nice weather next week.